The fuck? Why does it sound like a toilet? Alrighty then. What's going on, guys? Kardak here. So, we are back with some more Astroneer. Yeah, today's main focus is going to be unlocking more research pods and getting our truck nice and fixed up. I hope y'all like that little intro shot there. It's fucking awesome. I don't know how I managed to get him to stand just perfectly like that, you know, brave adventurer, explorer, whatever. But yeah, that's probably going to be the thumbnail. But you'll know before you knew I said this. So yeah, anyway, I'm going to get a few things built that will help me out with that endeavor. Namely, I need more of these little storage racks here. So compound is in our future. But for now, go ahead, make, I've got plenty of power on the base. I've got two tiny solar panels, two tiny turbines, one big and one of each also. So we'll go ahead and add on to our storage capacity. We'll take these two things with us whenever we go with a truck. I am going to open up a little, like, I'm going to build like a bridge. And most of the time, people say, you know, don't fucking take your vehicle underground. It's bad. You'll never get it back. And to an extent, yeah, that's right. You run the risk of losing it for fucking ever or making it incredibly, incredibly difficult. But I'm the type of person that I just ignore what people tell me to do and I just do what I want to and learn the hard way that I shouldn't have done that. So that's what we're going to go with today. Let me see here. What have I got in my backpack already? I've got some more compound. Oh, excuse me. Been drinking Dr. Pepper all afternoon, so a little burpy. I got some more compound tethers. I don't really need the tethers right now because, I mean, everywhere that we were at earlier, I tethered out, and now it's relatively easy to get around down there. We got a lot of copper and stuff. I did unlock the trade platform last episode. If you haven't seen it, there'll be a link right above my head, right about like right here. Yeah, so you'll see a link right here that will be to the other video if you want to check that one out. I always could appreciate some support and some views and whatnot. I mean, if you want to be just so generous as to leave a like, that would also be great. But, yeah, so today we're going to go back over to our little mountain. We've got our truck. I'm not going to bring a solar panel along with me just because, I mean, for the most part, the truck's just going to sit there. It's not going to do anything. And I don't think, and I might be wrong on this, I know that you can draw power from the truck off the tethers. What I don't know is whether it'll do it if the tethers also run to the base. But I guess there's really only way to find out, right? So who knows, maybe this will be a don't do this guide. But first things first, we are going to build us just this gigantic fucking bridge down into here. So that way when I do take my truck down there, I can get it back the fuck out. And that's what this lovely little train editing tool that they've got is for. So I want to pick something that's not too steep, but not like so shallow that it's going to be forever fucking long trying to get it back up there. So I think I'm probably about there. So yeah, all you got to do for this is just hold down control and start digging, and I hear a storm coming. So good timing. But yeah, as long as it's wide enough that it can get... Whoa, what the fuck is going on here? That's right. Keep feeding me with power, base. Keep feeding me with power. Why is it doing weird shit? It's supposed to just be eating. There we go. That's better. Oops, shit. What the fuck? Why does it... What is it doing? Did I, like, momentarily let off control or something? I don't know. I'll pop back in once this is all done, though. want to pop back in and show y'all really quick. So that answers that question. Yes, it will suck the power loose even if you're on the fucking, even if you're attached permanently to the base. That's unfortunate. More so because I don't see any power nodes. Well, there's some suns coming up, so that's not so bad. And I'm going to be underground. So, yeah, we're going to do this. So that way I can stop having to worry about getting some fucking power while I'm trying to do what I'm doing. Alright, so for the most part it's finished up now. We've got our little ramp down in here and a little flat area to park on. Pretty easy access from the rest of the cave system. I do need to clean this up over here a little bit, but it's no big deal. But yeah, the idea is I'm just going to bring it down here, park it right the fuck here, and start dragging over fucking resources. Eventually, once I've upgraded the storage for it, I will also be dragging over a shit ton of research pods and stack up on all these nice expensive stuff that isn't really easy to find on this planet. I would like to see more of a weather system in here, you know, rain and stuff, and it affecting the terrain for, you know, organics growing back or, you know, stuff like that. Just little stuff. Nothing, you know, make or break on the how good the game is. Like, it is a really fantastic game, and I'm really enjoying playing it, and I'm sliding down this hill more than I'm driving, but whatever. Alright, we're gonna have to move a tether over to it to keep it powered up. Unless I can park it just close enough. No? Okay. Alright, there we go. Cool! Alright, so now we've got our little ramp set up. But yeah, we're gonna start on the resource grind now. I'll skip all that stuff. I'll come back to you once I filled up the truck's bays with all the goodies. The fuck? Why does it sound like a toilet? Alrighty then. Alright, so we run around and collected a lot of fucking copper. I'm gonna load up my pack real quick with this hydrazine, and then we're gonna head back over to the surface. Make a trading platform, hopefully, from the results of all those damn research pods. If we can make a trading platform, I'm gonna sell all this fucking I'm gonna sell a lot of that copper for just aluminum and lithium. I could really use some lithium right now. I need to get me some batteries so that this no power bullshit will quit happening. Because if I'm not mistaken, I'm draining my damn truck right now. And it's not going to help me when it comes time to get back. In fact, give me a research pod while I'm at it. Thank you. Anything else good over here? Doesn't look like it. Alright, cool. So, we'll just take what we got now. I probably need to pick up some more compound while I'm out, actually. So, do that on the way back. I can fit another one on there, right? Yeah. Alright, cool. Be interesting to see if they stay. So, I know that sometimes stuff can get knocked off if you hit something too hard, so. I do not like trying to back up these things. Okay. can I get up this hill? Am I really hung up because of the fucking research pod? Fine, I'll come back for you. Okay. That's better. See, this is why you don't bring your truck down into the fucking mines. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, get out of there. There we go. Alright, so note to self, clean that up when I get back. I'll be coming back with some tethers next time, so that I'll actually be able to see what the fuck I'm doing. Over there. Oh, come on! No, don't do this to me! How? How does that even... Oh, is it really out of power? Why are you still driving? Stop. No. Stop. Wonderful. That's why. Because it was completely out of fucking power. And now we wait until daytime. Hopefully this will give my truck enough juice to get me at least back to the house. Sun's up again, so... Let's try this again. Without all the, you know, failing. Oh, and we're free. Plenty of power, too. Alright, good deal. Let's get our asses back to the fucking base. Why am I not drawing power off these lines? That's really fucking annoying. They could definitely do a lot to improve the power system in this game. Just I don't know. Maybe they're doing this intentionally just to make it, you know, a little more challenging, a little more, you have to be a little more mindful of what's going on. But at the same time, like, power has been nothing but a problem for me since I started doing this shit. And I'm just like, come on, you know, cut me some slack. But, you know, whatever. It's their game. They can make it how they want it. Oh, what do you know? Speak of the fucking devil, I got some lithium now. Alright. Hurry up and smelt all this while it's still daytime. Nice. Alright, so I've got literally enough copper to fucking build a power plant. Come on. You fucking just want that piece of copper on that storage. Thank you. Alright, get this thing juiced up right quick. I wonder. Is there anything else I can make that uses copper, or is it only the generator? Yeah, it's just the generator. If I'm not mistaken, that trade platform, is that copper or is that aluminum? I think it's aluminum. Now we need aluminum. So the hunt for some more aluminum begins. I will pop back up as soon as I have found some aluminum, or if something interesting happens. Really like it if one of these would pop out some aluminum, but I don't think we're gonna discover anything. Nope. Oh, but we have two lithium now. Yes, that means I can get batteries. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Astroneer gods. I can start building up on juice. Juice! Alright. All that spinning that these things are doing will actually have some fucking purpose now. Excellent. Why isn't it wanting to... Okay, that was weird. Whatever. It's a new one. What we got? Spaceship, spaceship, spaceship. Storage. Well, we got a big storage thing for the back of the truck now. That's nice. Coal, you can go over here because you're going on the trade platform as soon as I get one. So I got some more aluminum. What was I going to use aluminum for? Trade platform, dumbass. Jesus Christ. It's been a hectic morning. My YouTube namesake, Cardock, actually comes from what my nickname was back when I was still in the active duty. A lot of people would call me the car doctor because, you know, they could bring me their cars and more often than not I could fix them no matter what the problem was. Well, it's stuck, and I'm a pretty solid mechanic. There'll be some videos of me doing that kind of shit later on down the line. But anyway, I digress. This morning, go to swap out my brakes and my rotors on my daily driver, only to find out the brakes that Amazon assured me would fit on my car don't fit on my car. So I gotta wait a week so that BMW can actually get my brakes for my car shipped in. And yeah, it's been a morning. Out of frustration, I decided, you know what, YouTube videos. It's going to be the rest of the day. Just YouTube videos. And another storm blows its way by. Alrighty then. I'm waiting on that fucking thing to come back from my aluminum, or my lithium. There it is. Yeah, I fucked up. So I sent off all that fucking copper. But I accidentally ordered unrefined copper. Let's see what some coal might net us. No. Lithium's so freaking valuable that it won't one for one with anything. But those two coal can get me the other lithium that I need for some more batteries. Because I'm about to need the batteries. Because the next step is going to be building a fucking wall around my base. Alrighty then. So, progress report. We've got two batteries now. Doing pretty good. We got a pretty broad spectrum of methods to gather power. I'm going to take this old thing back down in there. I'm going to load up on... I'm not going to collect anything but aluminum while I'm down there. And aluminum and the little storage pods. I'm going to do my best to not leave the planet until I've gotten a hold of the spaceship, because I hate going to these new planets and not having the right amount of resources, because it is incredibly difficult when you get to a new planet to get yourself established properly, and you got to struggle and sacrifice way more than I like to do when you first start up. So, I'm gonna keep running around, collecting up some shit, and With any luck, I'll come across a nice big old patch of aluminum and be able to, and I'll be able to unlock the spaceship and everything else, and we'll actually, you know, be able to do something with ourselves. Although I could refine all this copper. I could get a bunch of refined copper. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Really good chance I'm just going to wind up collecting only the aluminum I find. But if given the opportunity, if all I can find is copper, I'll just come back, refine all of it, and order some unrefined aluminum. Well, I guess I'll take these with me, because four of these refined is four unrefined aluminum. So, may as damn well, right? Oh, hello. Alrighty then. See, that's the kind of thing I'm talking about. Alright, so let's find a good angled one. Alright, well, we got a nice loadout of research pods. I think I'm going to run out, collect the rest of that aluminum and copper, and then we'll head back up topside, and I'll quit running around in caves for a little while. I might just go ahead and bite the bullet and head off into space, but that'll be next episode if I do. Right now, I'm mostly focused on, I'm so hoping that I can get a hold of that spaceship within the next couple of research pods, but if I'm not able to, I'm probably going to get really impatient and just say fuck it and go for it without doing it the way I want to. Which, truth be told, is probably not the smartest thing to do, but, you know, make do with what you got, so. I've got no fancy spaceship. So let's think for a second. So, trade platforms need aluminum. Fuel condensers need copper. So I need at least two copper and two aluminum. Now to get those, I'm going to need six more resin. To build this thing, I'm going to need four aluminum. No, compound I need. I need compound to do the shuttle. I got plenty of hydrazine sitting around right now, so not really worried about fueling it, and making more is just that simple. So let's see here. Right, we'll start going ahead and building up this storage bay with what we need. So that will be for the initial off of that. Let's see, so trade platform, fuel condenser, printer, any more aluminum. Alright, so here we go. Off into the wild blue yonder. And it looks like we've got a planet close orbit right now, so that's going to be our first stop. I'm thinking, what is that? Is that a tundra planet? I hear this one's a real challenge to live on. Oh no, it just got out of the orbit. Alright, so yeah, as you can see, it's a small solar system. There's five planets, and we have one little moon, but it's just a barren moon. There's really not anything good up there as far as resources go, so I generally speak and don't waste my time going to it. It's going to be a minute before any planets come into orbit, but I'll let y'all see a beautiful little time lapse of it, so y'all can, for y'all's enjoyment. Alright, so it looks like our first lovely little planet has come in here. I don't know. Like, there's no air, there's no organic materials over here, but there's a lot of resources. Now, we'll give this one a shot. If I'm not mistaken, it's the closest planet in the solar system to this one, so generally speaking, jumping to it's not that much of a trouble. As you can see, I have already spent my two extra pods, and I'm working through the ones I've got right now. And wow, this looks really weird. Alright, so let's see. What are we going to pick out here? Do that one. That looks nice. I like that one. And it's daytime right now, so it'll actually look really, really nice when we land, hopefully. And a little bit of a hole, but nothing crazy. And look at what we just landed right next to. Titanium and lithium. Fuck yes. Alright, so here we are on our first new planet. I'm gonna wrap it up here, guys. We'll check back in. Probably in a couple of days, I'll have another video up. I really do hope y'all enjoyed it. I hope y'all are enjoying the series. I'm going to be putting out videos, like I think I said this last episode too, but I'm going to be trying to put out videos once every couple of days or so for the time being. And if it starts actually getting a lot of, like, you know, appreciation and whatnot, I guess I'll do them more often. But yeah, that's all for today. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will catch y'all in the next one. Bye-bye.